Always to be the country, there is no monopoly for any people in this country on the basis of nationalism. Everybody in this country is patriot and everybody is nationalist. They adore the country. They, when there is a need for any sacrifice for the country, the minorities were always in the forefront in making the sacrifices for the welfare and the progress of the country. And sir, refusing to recognize their existence even now, that is a crime against the nation, in my very humble words. Sir, the constitution protected their rights under Article 25 to 30. Even now, because I repeat all these things, even yesterday, much of our time was wasted to discuss this minority. Why the appeasement of minority? What is this appeasement? They are far below the national average. And if something is done by the government to protect them, to bring them forward, then it is appeasement. What is this word appeasement of the English dictionary means? That our honorable friends must explain, not only to this august house but to the country. Sir, the national leaders recognize this. Sometimes appeasement, sometimes questioning the loyalty. Sir, I am just reminded of here, formerly the minorities of the country were called Babar ke Aulad, the sons of Babar. Now they have changed the stand. Now they say the minorities, they are not minorities, because the blood that flows in their veins are the blood of the same Hindu brethren. They are not come from outside, so they are not minorities. This is the latest stand. They are changing the stance that suits their own political stand. But sir, whatever may be the description, they are Indians and they belong to
this country. Please conclude, Mr. Sam.
Sir, I am concluding, sir. Just 2 minutes. Sir, now 99.9% of Muslims and Christians have not come from outside. They cannot be called minorities. This is the statement, the latest statement of a leader whose name I would not like to quote here, but it is the statement. Sir, there is blind hatred. The Muslims, Christians and the other minorities are 100% Indians, and they will remain Indians, whatever may be the oppositions. There are some sections in our country who are double minorities. For example, sir, Kashmiri Muslims, they are ethnical minorities and religion minorities. There are the Christians in the Northeast. They are religious minorities as well as ethnic minorities. So, sir, everywhere in the world now there is a movement going on for the protection of the minorities. And our country has paved way for that. We are the forerunners in this respect. And we can't go behind from our stand of affecting all sections of our country. India is a country of different religions, cultures and language. Therefore, its strength, solidarity, stability and progress, sir, depend upon the unity and harmony of all sections. And sir, I am reminded of the statement of Miss Mary Robinson, who was the UN High Commission for Human Rights, and now she is the head of the Ethnical Globalization Initiative. She says, the ideal of equality is, after all, the touchstone on which the guarantees of international human rights have been built. It is the principle of non-discrimination. Ultimately, we are all striving to ensure inclusiveness and an end forever to exclusion and all forms of discrimination. I think the government's move is in the right direction to avoid discrimination and to ensure inclusion. For that, this kind of steps are very much essential. Even Sir Ramakrishna Mission have petitioned the Calcutta High Court that they should be declared as a religious minority. I don't know what will be the reaction of our friends to this thing, but they have approached. They are having their own sets of beliefs and customs. So they argue and they want that they have to be recognized as a minority. Sir, finally, I would like to say that everywhere there is this cartoon issue, all these issues, they are the symptoms of the same disease. All over the world, there is effort, very serious effort, to bring contradictions, to bring fights, to bring feuds. And this so-called Western theory of clash among civilizations, that is a menace to humanity, sir, because they are bringing to create feud. They are bringing to create tension in the world. What we want in today's world is vigilance against imperialism, a vigilance against every theory of clash among cultures, civilizations. Sir, these religious personalities have to be respected, whether of Hindus, of Muslims or Christians. Devi, Devada, prophets, acharyas, everybody, they have to be respected. Whether it is any artist, artists, freedom of expression does not mean to wound the faith of the crores and crores of people who live in this world. They should not have given such a freedom. That will create a tension.
Please come.
Sir Plato, in his Republic, he said, in my country, in my state, that is in my conception, there will not be any relevance for so-called artists who destroy the discipline of the country. I congratulate once again the government and the Honorable Prime Minister for all the concrete steps for the protection of the welfare of the minorities, and I support this motion.
With a couplet of Iqbal.
Sir, I would like to just conclude. Na samjhoge to mit jaoge e Hindustan walo, teri barbaad ke mashware hai aasmanon mein. Thank you.